his honor. He deserves for me to literally come to the very spot and deliver. That's where I'm going now, brothers and sisters. I was thinking to myself, if that happened to me, if that was to happen to me personally, I might just say, you know what? Take the property and leave. I felt saddened that a life has been taken. I had to come to this very spot and where it happened to salute, to make dua for this brother. You know why? Because he is a soldier. He doesn't need anyone to feel sorry for him. Yes, what's happened at the situation, the family has lost a dear son. But wallahi, I'm here because this brother was a soldier. This brother was a warrior. This brother implemented the very hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam.
So, usually I could do this video at home. You know, it's easy, face the cam. But I'm going to head to where our brother Hussein was passed away. Yeah? The reason I'm going to go there is because I feel like it's at least a form of honouring him. You know, I could do this at home. But seeing and hearing how this all went about, how he was killed, and how he was defending his family, his property, his honor, he deserves for me to literally come to the very spot and deliver. That's where I'm going now, brothers and sisters, because this man is, yani, is someone special, brothers. You know, he's someone really special. And I'm going to tell you guys a hadith, a Quran, ayah, inshallah, and I'm going to share a reminder with you guys, because what this guy did has really, really made me proud as a Muslim to have him as a brother, to know that men like him exist. In today's age, men like him exist. And he changed my perception about the whole thing so much, what he did, because I would have not done that. But we're going to head now, inshallah, brothers and sisters, to the very spot on Lee Bridge Road, inshallah, where this brother, inshallah, was martyred, inshallah, yeah? This guy was a brave young warrior. And I'm going to tell you guys what happened, and we're going to learn some benefits from the hadith of the Prophet, peace be upon him, inshallah. I'll see you guys there.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh, brothers and sisters and dear friends. Behind me, in the very place our brother passed away. SubhanAllah. Brothers and sisters, when I heard this story, it's heartbreaking. It's heartbreaking, and it really makes one really understand. Anybody that has doubt about, you know, why did God create hellfire, it sometimes makes sense to you. When cowards, individuals who come and take a person's life in such a way, hellfire makes really perfect sense to me. Now, when I was watching this, brothers and sisters, and when I was hearing about what happened, in my head, I was thinking to myself, if that happened to me, if that was to happen to me personally, I might just say, you know what? Take the property and leave. Who cares about it? You know, it's just property. And when I saw the reminder from Brother Musa's page, and he shared the hadith of the Prophet, peace be upon him, where this is the following, what he was said, and it really shook me. And to the point where, when I felt saddened that a life has been taken, I had to come to this very spot and where it happened, to salute, to make dua for this brother. You know why? Because he is a soldier. He doesn't need anyone to feel sorry for him. Yes, what's happened at the situation, the family has lost a dear son. But wallahi, I'm here because this brother was a soldier. This brother was a warrior. This brother implemented the very hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. How? The Messenger of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, said, a man came to him and he said, if a man comes to seize my property, O Messenger of Allah, what should I do? He said, you should not give up your wealth, your property, whatever it is. He said, O Messenger of Allah, what if he fights me for it? He said, if he fights you, you fight him back. He said, O Messenger of Allah, what if he kills me? He said, if he kills you, you are a martyr. He said, O Messenger of Allah, what if I kill him? He says, if you kill him, he will end up in the hellfire. Brothers and sisters, when I heard this, and I thought, SubhanAllah, SubhanAllah, wallahi, what a brave man. He is in his house earning a halal income, number one. He's not on the street selling drugs. He's not going around killing people like these two cowards did. Yeah? He is there providing for his family members. Number one, earning a halal income. He's at the duty of his mother, obedience to the mother. Like Allah says in the Quran, after we ask you to obey us, do not say off to your mother. Be obedient to your parents. Yeah? He is there at the service of his mother. So much so that these two cowards come into his house with the intention of buying a jacket. And what did they do? They tried to rob him. And he could have easily put a story. He could have easily said, you know what, take it and leave. He didn't. He decides to fight them. And he fought them like a man. SubhanAllah. And brothers and sisters, SubhanAllah, he died in the very spot defending his mother. What an honorable man. These are the kind of men that we're talking about who defend the honor. And the Prophet, peace be upon him, also told us that if a person fights defending his family is a martyr. A person who defends and fights defending his religion is a martyr. And the person who fights defending his property is a martyr, brothers and sisters. What a soldier. Wallahi, if he was alive today, wallahi, I would want to go and kiss him on the forehead. What a beautiful man. What a real man to come and defend his family, that his mother's being attacked, and subhanAllah, he puts his own life in danger. SubhanAllah. Brothers and sisters, there's a hadith of the Prophet, peace be upon him also. He said, on the day of one of the signs of the day of judgment is what? That a person will be killing, and the one he's killing doesn't know why he's being killed, and the one who's being killed doesn't know why he's being why he's killing. One doesn't know why he's killing, the other doesn't know why he's being killed for. Brothers and sisters, this is the times that we live in. The signs of their judgment, subhanAllah, that people are being killed for a mere damn jacket. A mere damn jacket. Why? Because it's designer. Why? So I'm going to get this jacket and I'm going to be in a video or whatever and I'm going to show up. And where does this stem from? Where does this stem from, brothers and sisters? It's our corrupt society. Money, fame, and all this kind of stuff. Why people want to prove a point? They are not happy. They are not content with the things that they have. And if they cannot afford it, they're going to go out there and take people's souls. They're going to take people's lives so they can, what? Show off. Do an Instagram picture, a Facebook picture, a post, a YouTube video. Look at my jacket. Something that you can't even own yourself, just to point, prove a point to other people. If this is not enslavement, if this is not slavery, wallahi, there is no slavery. We are enslaved to our society so much so that we are too busy proving things to others that we will come and take an innocent person's life. An innocent person's life is taken. Why? So I can wear some expensive jacket, so I can show off to this person or that person. And alhamdulillah, when I came to Islam, I broke those shackles. What do I mean by that? And I want to end on this note, brothers and sisters. Yeah? And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make this brother a martyr, inshallah. Inshallah, he's a martyr. And you know, a martyr will be interceding for his family members, 70 of his family members. My auntie, if you're listening to this, the mother of this child, what an honorable mother you are. What an honorable mother you are, that you have brought up such a soldier into this world. In your arms, you gave birth to a soldier. And subhanAllah, you, in your very arms, that very soldier took his last breath while taking the shahada. Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah wa ashhadu anna Muhammadan abduhu wa rasuluh. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant him the highest levels of Jannah, brothers and sisters. And subhanAllah, brothers and sisters, we ask you guys and these two cowards, the cowards, anybody, whoever they are, to take somebody's life over a damn jacket is a cowardly act. And you know, sometimes you feel sorry for these people. You know why? They're caught up in the system, this society, these music videos, these dual music videos, etc., trying to prove yourself, trying to live a lifestyle that you can't afford. SubhanAllah, brothers and sisters, this is why Islam has come, to free you from the shackles of enslavement to society, to fame, to money, to your society, to your friends, to the enslavement to the one who's created you, because he's the one that deserves you to be a slave to him. And that is when you bear and understand what true freedom is, brothers and sisters. There's been a GoFundMe page that has been set up, and inshallah, if you guys can go and be a sadaqah jariyah for our soldier, for our brother, a warrior. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant him the highest rank of Jannah. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give patience to his mum. Brothers and sisters, we ask you guys to make dua and give, donate to the sadaqah jariyah, inshallah. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless you guys. May Allah protect every single one of us. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.